Hello, and welcome to another Fleet Ops audio commentary brought to you today by Clint Set and special guest commentator Zyke.
Hi, how you doing?
Alrighty, so we'll do a quick intro of the players and get into the commentary. So at the top, we have Acheron as the Purple Feds. He's starting out pretty basic Starfleet engineering and storage dock, so probably see some Intrepids, Monsoons, things like that. His ally here is Funny Stuff, or actually, sorry, it's Nuke as the Green Romulans. Did not expect to see him as Romulans. So he's setting up his Star Yard and Dilithium Mining. Pretty standard there, too. They are up against the Red Federation, played by Dragonfire. He's doing same basic engineering, Dilithium Mining. And we've got Funny Stuff Pictures as the Blue Feds. So, Blue Borg. I am out of it today, Zyke. This is horrible. He's rolling with an optimized avatar here. Alrighty, so last game was a pretty strong Fed Romulan push. They switched up the teams, and we'll see what happens.
Yeah, I'm interested to see. Nukov has Q2rians and one of the new Generex.
I love those little guys. Those gens, they look mean. They look pretty nasty. And when you see those torpedoes flying out, you do get nervous.
Yeah, the new Generex is definitely a torp machine. Particularly, it's gonna be good against the Borg.
Yeah, a lot of people have been concerned because they do have a higher mischance against early things like the Scubes, but I like what Nuke's doing. He's got those Riens are going to help him out early on. He's going to be able to tank if he gets phase plates, and the Gens will push out some DPS. Some Monsoons coming up from Dragonfire. Counter those Riens, and looks like we've got good Monsoon Intrepid mix. And would you look at that, going after the detector. Let's see if Funny notices. Looks like he does. That can be very annoying.
Yeah.
Like this map, Stardust has updated it so that you've got pretty good expansion options. I like that you got one player that has to expand forward to the enemy, so it sets it up a little more exposed. I think they are spying on our Borg friend over here. He's already setting up some skews.
Mm-hmm. Interested to see what kind of skews he's gonna work with.
Yeah, before you pretty much always saw intercepts and maybe if he had some sort of cloaker running around, but now you start to see a little more regen. That peripheral skew's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it's definitely the peripheral skew is definitely a great asset for Borg players who want to do that early harassing sort of thing, because you can just buff your smaller ships that you can get up pretty early.
Yeah, and if you have regen skews later on, you're able to keep them alive, give them a nice little boost while you wait for the next harassing move. So a lot more options for the Borg. It's pretty cool. I'm definitely seeing a lot of different strategies running around. And people trying to figure out what works best, especially with the upcoming tournament that I'll shamelessly plug here. We got a tournament getting ready to go. Today is the last day to sign up, but we should have some pretty good replays coming up off that. Lots of games scheduled. I think there's going to be something like probably a couple hundred by the time the tournament ends.
I'm really looking forward to that tournament. It's going to be great to see all those different matches, particularly with the new patch out.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons I wanted to do it right after a new patch. It gives people some options. They get to experiment with some new things. You don't see the same strategy over and over again. Looks like Nuke switched to some Lavals mixed with Gens, and I like that. I like to mix up those little more expensive Lavals with the little bit easier to manage cost-wise gens.
Yeah, the Lavals are a really impressive ship to be working with the Gens.
Yeah, they just do so much damage. They tank quite well. They are my nemesis when I'm against the Romulans.
Yeah, particularly when they have that metaphasic phaser on them, the metaphasic disruptor. It's just a nice little ping to one off some ships.
And would you look at that? The Romulans on the left took that back expansion. So Feds are going to have to expand really close to the enemy out on the really exposed moons. Interesting. That is really interesting.
And we see some Borg ships moving around to maybe do some raiding.
Yeah, they are going
So.
to tear this thing up. There's nothing that's going to stop those.
Those Romulan miners are so fragile that
Oh, he's gonna see those coming, and I wonder if he'll turn around these miners. Yeah, there they go. Oh, that's so
Interesting.
gross. They're just gonna fly down.
Oh, those poor Romulans.
Yeah, you got those Reman slaves sitting on there, just waiting to get killed. Yeah, and this is it's pretty good. The Borg able to get a few kills off. Fed not gonna be able to do much with those two monsoons. It's like, oh, and both players, both
Two
Feds,
warpins.
right next to each other. And almost identical.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we can just see how rare those new warpins are. We haven't seen one yet, but I bet we'll see at least one in this game.
Yeah, I bet we'll see a Centaur at some point.
Oh, EM Scube catching the Laval, and they are going to try to steal it. They might get it. Oh, they're not gonna get it now. Looks like
They're not gonna get it, not with the starbase beaming and the research beaming.
Oh, so close though. Good grief. And pulled them out of combat though. Saved the Scubes. They're gonna get some monsoon kills potentially, or well, maybe not. Warpin coming in and do some damage. And that, my friends, is Funny Stuff Pictures. Still quickest in the world on that transport key. They made some changes to cloak beaming, though. Without cloak detect, you really can't just steal ships near as easy. And that, my friends, is a great thing. So, wow, I'm just really amazed at that expansion strategy in the back. Love to see players mix it up a little bit. It's like Dragonfire's
Looks
expanding
like,
in.
yeah, and we see the feds in the upper right are expanding all the way up to the in that little back end with this little dilithium boom.
Yeah, that's. And Funny might figure that out when he sees that miner going off in the middle of nowhere. He might just realize that there might be something juicy up there.
Although it looks like he pulled back the miner a little bit, so.
Funny just trying to figure out what he can do to try to keep the Fed numbers down.
That's definitely what you want to do when you start seeing warp-ins coming in.
Oh, it's gonna have some Romulan friends there. Definitely gonna help. And a peripheral Scube coming out. Looks like it's gonna meet up with this nice fleet. I wonder how much damage they can do.
Although that Fed and Romulan fleet combined, it's probably a match for this Borg fleet, though we have the Dragonfire's Fed fleet coming up.
Yeah, it's gonna be. That's a lot of ships. Gonna be pretty interesting to see how those monsoons do. Laval should eat them up, so we'll see how that works. And they are getting themselves really out of position. And And there's the peripherals cube going off, and we see cloak detect. And some extra damage coming from those cubes. Consume's going down. Oh, love to see those specials working. Love the new torpedo sounds too. Just adds a little more oomph.
I think the fact that Dragonfire has researched the proxy torpedo is definitely giving him the edge against the other Fed players.
Yeah, a little bit of extra oomph there. And these Borg ships really do a pretty good job of dishing out some DPS. Look at them go. And I think they're going to try to stop this Roddy Yard from going up there. They did it. Stopped him, and they're going to get the kill. Once his shields go down, it is toast. Monsoon's doing a good job tanking for those cubes, taking a little bit of fire from the starbase, and now they're running away. This is not looking too good for the left-hand team. Romulans are engaging the mining of the Fed, so they're not alone here, but I'm not sure they can do the same kind of damage. How long are the next warp in? Looks like, oh, just used, so... Oof. Ouchie, ouchie, ouchie. And still, Fed still has a decent number of ships.
Teutoburg incoming.
Oh, there it goes! There it goes!
You were poked.
Oh, and he's activated both specials at the same time. That can really eat into its special energy.
Look at that. Yeah, but look at the damage. Poor E1 just getting fried. Look at that. Teutoburg. Can tell, it looks like he's losing line of sight though. And oh, the cubes.
Those cubes are just tearing apart that expansion.
Yeah, it's ripping it apart.
and there's the GG.
I think it's a mite early. I think they still have a shot. Definitely a psychological blow there.
Yeah.
Well, another good game. Thank the players for giving us that good show, and thank you guys for watching, and thank you, Zyke, for adding in some extra flavor.
Thanks for having me.
See you guys later.